Go ahead and worship him tonight. Please go ahead and worship him tonight. Worship him tonight. Worship him tonight from the depth of your heart. Worship him tonight. Call him by his name. 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 Wonderful God. Glorious God. Mighty God. Excellent God. Powerful God. Reliable God. Dependable God. Worship him tonight. Worship him from the depth of your heart. Call him the name you know him to be. Your healer, your provider, your shield, your buckler, your director, your sustainer. Please call him by the name. It's Yahweh, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Shammai, Jehovah Elohim, Jehovah Elohika. Jehovah Jireh, worship him, worship him, worship him. Adagbama tepa, obaton tadele te otonile, obaton lokori kese, ogbonu mudia shola, ogbonu adele ba shogo, obalan obalan ya ba chayira ye, aiku, aisha, aibibaje, worship him tonight. Worship him tonight. In Jesus' mighty name, we have worship. To God be the glory. We are what we are by his grace. It's not by the works of our hands. It's not because we know how to pray. Standing in his presence is by his grace. This happened, today happens to be the last SOR in the month of April. There are people that we started together.
The month of April, they are no more alive. Many are in the hospital. Many are in the psychiatric hospital. Many have been buried. But you are in the sanctuary. Oh, go ahead and appreciate him. Go ahead and appreciate him for covenant of life. Appreciate him for provision. Appreciate him for directing your path. Appreciate him. You are not put to shame. Appreciate him. You are not on the street begging before you could eat. Appreciate God. Appreciate him. Appreciate him. Please appreciate him for your going out and coming in. The scripture says he will preserve you. Appreciate him. He never leaves you nor forsake thee. Appreciate him. In Jesus' mighty and wonder-working name, we have given thanks. By the special grace of God, the said man of God that God is going to use to, for us tonight, we'll be talking on the topic, the power of vision through faith. The power of vision through faith. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I want you to pray for the said man of God that God is going to use tonight, that the Almighty God will use him mightily, that his heaven will be open, that this meeting, let our heavens be open. Father, touch him to touch us. Shall we go ahead and talk to the Lord? Shall we please go ahead and talk to the Lord? Father, touch the set man that you have prepared for us tonight to touch us. Father, touch him to speak to us, to address our situation. Lord, tonight we have come to seek you, Lord. Father, touch your son that you are prepared to minister unto us tonight in the name of Jesus. Father, touch your son to touch my life, to address my situation tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. My coming here tonight shall not be in vain. Let his heaven be open. Let my heavens be open. And let there be outpouring of your miracle, signs and wonders in the name of Jesus Christ. When we talk about the power of vision, what is vision? Vision is seen tomorrow, even today. God said to Abraham, as many as you can see, you will possess. What are you seeing tonight? You need to put your faith into it. That's just it. What you are seeing ahead, it is by faith that we come to manifestation, sir. President, I've said it here severally. Before you see the manifestation, you must have seen it in the spirit realm. Before this building was constructed, he has seen it the way it must be, spiritually. And it came to reality. That is vision, seeing it ahead. Help me to put my faith into it. Go ahead and pray. Tonight, O Lord, that thing I have been seeing, O Lord, in the spirit realm, bring it to reality today. Father, bring it to reality. Let my faith, O Lord, work for me that it will come to manifestation in the name of Jesus. Hospital to meet the doctor. And the doctor said, sister, brother, this sickness will take your life. That you have just little time to spend. What is scripture saying? I shall not die, but live to declare the works of the Lord. If you can see that you will live, you will discover that you will live. And the report of the doctor, you become nuts, because that is your vision. Seeing it ahead, and it comes to reality. Say, Father, where I have been written off, let my vision and my faith push me to my vision reality. Go ahead and pray. Bring my vision to reality by my faith tonight. I will exercise my faith in you, Lord. Lord God Almighty, let my vision come to reality. Let every negativity concerning me come to naught. And let faith help me, Lord, to bring it to reality in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we are praying. See, I'll stop on this last prayer point. The man of God, the set man, the Lord has prepared to bring the word. Even if he has prepared for many days, and that preparation, where by the time you begin to deliver the word, you will not gain anything. I want you to pray. Father, touch him now so that he will address my situation. That my vision, through him, my faith can come to reality. Go ahead and talk to the Lord. No matter how the set man has prepared, Father, touch him to touch me tonight. In the name of Jesus, Father, touch him to touch me tonight.
The Lord will touch you tonight according to your prayer. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Let the living shout hallelujah. I read from the book of Daniel, chapter 4, verse 34, very quickly. And it reads, "And at the end of the days, I, Nebuchadnezzar, lifted up my eyes unto heaven, and my understanding returned unto me, and I blessed the Most High, and I praise and honor him that liveth forever, whose dominion is an everlasting dominion, and his kingdom is from generation to generation." Praise the Lord. It's time for testimony. The Almighty God has done something wonderful in your life and you want to share to the glory of God. And for the benefit of the listeners, please, can we see your hand? God has done something. 1, 2, 3, 4. Please, you can come up very quickly. Please go straight to the point. No singing because of our time. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. My name is Queen Louisa. I am here to return glory to the Almighty God. Few of us here must have heard or know about my situation. This, my daughter, she's my fourth daughter. She has been bleeding and she has been passing through this situation for 4 good years. But come last year, December, it becomes so severe that she was helpless, she was hospitalized, she was lying down, the only cloth upon this child's body was paint. She can change up to 34 times in a day. She bleeded to nothing. I sent the pictures to mommy. If they display it in the screen, we could know and believe indeed that there is God. But there was one thing very sure. Upon all those period that I was in the hospital since last year, I came back a few weeks ago. But there was one thing that was sure. Our cloth was coming to church every day. Our cloth was coming to vigil every day. There was no activity that our cloth did not appear. And I say, God, if only thou can rescue the life of this child, that I can return back home with my daughter, I can return back to Zion with my daughter, I will testify of thy goodness. She was on that same bed. She was appointed to come outside the nation to come and minister because she's a youth minister. While she was lying down, we were weeping out to close the grave, but the Lord said, no, there is a promotion for you outside. She was sent for to come and minister outside Nigeria. Just few days to the time, we went to the airport just for her to board. She started coughing, and that disqualified the traveling. She had a heartbreak. I said, God, this thing will not bring this girl down. I want you to encourage this child for me. I want you to strengthen this child. Just after some few days later, they say you have missed your conference. We book you for next year conference. Our God is good. He's a faithful God. And while I was in the hospital, there was no food for my children. God was using the mommy here to give my children food to eat. My 5 kids was out of school. They were just staying in the house. And God appeared in that situation that my children went back to school. I said, praise the Lord that my daughter is alive in Zion. She is bouncing and she's walking. And she has returned back to ministry in order to continue to serve God. There is a living God in this altar. Thank you, Jesus. Father, Lord, I worship you. I give you glory forever.
Praise the Lord. Who did it? Your testimony will be permanent in the name of Jesus. The next person, please, very quickly. The next person, the next testifier, please, can you come up? Testifier number two. Put your hands together as she's coming out. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. I want to bless the name of the Lord for the salvation of my soul and for being a bonafide member of TGC. I bless the name of the Lord for what he has been doing in my life and the life of my children. My baby that has got a scholarship, my last born. So last week Monday, on this Monday, the woman called me again and told me that I should come either on Wednesday or Thursday, that they've sent the bill for next term, which is 61,000, for me to come and collect and go and pay my baby's school fees. I just want to return all glory back to God because he's a faithful God. He has never left me nor forsake me. He has always been there for us in up and down. I thank him because he has always been encouraging me. He never lets me to go down. And I want to bless him for how far he has been blessing us. He has been surprising me. Anytime that I'm down, that there is nothing, in one way or the other, the Lord will always raise help for us. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. That's a wonderful testimony. God bless you, ma. The next testifier, please come out very quickly. God bless you. Put your hands together to encourage him. God bless you.
Good evening. I want to testify that on Monday when I was doing press up in my room, I landed on my thumb, and I want to thank God it didn't break.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. That was great. Thanks be to God for helping you that you didn't break your thumb.
Let somebody shout hallelujah. To the glory of God, I thank God that I'm alive because it's only when I'm alive that I can share testimony. Okay, I want to bless God. Last week, as in TGC, Daddy said that we're going to have, it will be our special week of emphasis. So we fasted that week, and even before he told us about the fast, I already made up my mind as at Sunday that week, at least for 3 days, will be for fasting. I want to thank God for how God took me through that fasting. I want to thank God that out of that fasting, God spoke to me after the fast. And I want to bless God specifically also for last week. There was something very uncommon that happened to me last week. While the message was going, or before Bro Austin came here to, you know, take us on the teaching of faith, I told God one thing. I said, God, as a reason of this message, build my faith. And so while the message was going on, I was learning some new things from what he was saying. And I just noticed that throughout that night was just quite very unusual. When I got home, I was in awe. I was just worshiping God. I could not really speak, I could not really pinpoint what was actually causing it. But I just knew that, you know, there were some things that he said, you know, that really stirred up my faith. And thank God I was even the only one at home. Because if my mother would have known, she would say, what is wrong with me that I'm not behaving normal? I was not really normal, honestly. I was just thanking God. I was giving God praise. I used it to I used the night for prayers. And even in the morning, while I was sleeping, I went to bed in praises to God. While I was sleeping, was it around that early in the morning? Yes, early in the morning. I don't know if it was a dream. I just heard for a particular scripture. I heard a particular scripture that from the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart, be made acceptable on. I just jumped out of my sleep. I still continue to give God the praise, God the worship, and I just bless the name of the Lord because even during that week, you know, I just saw by chance. I want to just believe that it was God that was leading me. I just saw by chance where, you know, in a particular WhatsApp group that I'm part of, they are mainly winners, where Papa said that this week let us use anointing oil concerning that, and I bless them that within that Faith Friday up till this week, I have been seeing tremendous miracles, you know, even in my business. God is helping me. I just want to bless the name of the Lord that where I was last week when it comes to spirituality is not where I am this week. I just give God all the praise. So many to say.
Praise the Lord. The Lord is good. So many other people are raising up their hands, but because of our time, I believe there's no one in this gathering in the presence of the Lord this evening without a testimony. That you could sit conveniently and comfortably is a testimony alone. Praise the Lord. May the testifier rise up on their feet as we. Okay, please, let's just take this one. Praise the Lord. God bless you.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Gift. I just want to thank God. I want to return all the glory to God for giving me a divine healing. Last week, I went to the hospital for the test results, and to God be all the glory. It was all negative, HIV 1 and 2 negative, hepatitis negative, the microbiology undergrowth negative. Everything was just negative. I also want to praise God. Praise the living Jesus.
Praise the Lord. He's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. What he has done for the testifiers, he will do in your life and in my life in the name of Jesus. Testifiers, please, could you rise up on your feet as we pray. Father, we thank you for your children that have given testimony concerning your faithfulness in your life. We ask, Lord, these testimonies will not be reversed in the name of Jesus. And as many that are looking up to you for one thing or the other in this gathering tonight, prove yourself as our Father and our God in the name of Jesus. Thank you because we know you have answered. Take all the glory, Lord. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Brethren, if you're happy tonight, shout hallelujah. No, that hallelujah is too small for my God. If you're happy, shout hallelujah. That's great. With the house of praise, we have a number. As you listen, remain blessed in Jesus' name. Oh,
Somebody shout hallelujah. If you are living, if you are alive, if you are in the presence of the Almighty God, if you are hallowed to be in His presence, let somebody shout hallelujah. Let the living shout hallelujah. House of Praise, God bless you. Power belongs to God. Power belongs to God. In heaven and in the earth, all power belongs
to God.
Power belongs to Him.
Power belongs to God.
Power belongs to Him.
Power belongs to God.
In heaven.
In heaven and the earth.
Belongs to God.
Victory belongs to God.
Victory belongs to God.
In heaven and the earth,
all power belongs to God.
God.
In heaven and the earth,
in heaven and the earth,
all victory belongs to God.
As far as heaven spread
above the earth,
you are exalted.
You are exalted.
Unlimited God.
Unlimited God.
Spread above the earth.
You are exalted.
You are exalted.
Unlimited God.
Unlimited God.
You are exalted.
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 Unlimited God,
you are exalted.
You are exalted.
You are exalted.
You are exalted.
Unlimited God,
the God that doeth the impossible. The God that maketh the difficult easy. The one that can do what no man can do. The I am that I am. The beginning and the ending. The author and finisher of our faith. The Lion of the tribe of Judah. The God who reigneth in heaven and on earth. The creator of the entire universe. The God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. The God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel. The one who stands and covereth the entirety. To your name alone be all the glory. Father, we bless you. You that can do what no man can do. We worship you. Glory, honor, thanks, adorations, exhortations, magnifications, worship, praises, adorations, O Lord, be ascribed unto your name, O Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. You picked Josiah at his age and you made him to make impact, not because of who he is, but because of who you are. Daddy, do it again and take all that glory. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. And let somebody shout hallelujah. Let the living shout hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. You are welcome to the presence of the awesome God. May his name alone be glorified in our lives in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. This evening we are going to listen to the word of God. And as he speaks to us, may we have listening ears, understanding minds, and may the word of God work for us in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Now let's open our Bibles to Genesis chapter 15. Genesis chapter 15. Genesis chapter 15. Are you there? Praise the Lord. I read from verse 1. After these things, the word of the Lord came unto Abram in a vision, saying, fear not, Abram. I am thy shield and thy exceeding great reward. And Abram said, Lord God, what wilt thou give me, seeing I go childless? And the steward of my house is this Eliezer of Damascus. And Abram said, behold, to me thou hast given no seed. And lo, one born in my house is mine heir. And behold, the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, this shall not be thine heir, but he that shall come forth out of thy own bowels shall be thy heir. And he brought him forth abroad and said, look now toward heaven and tell the stars, if thou be able to number them. And he said unto him, so shall thy seed be. And he believed in the Lord, and he counted it to him for righteousness. And he said unto him, I am the Lord that brought thee out of all of the Chaldees to give thee this land to inherit it. Let somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let the living shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. I pray for you, no matter where you are, no matter how deep where you are, no matter how in where you are, God will bring you forth. He will make you to look up to heaven, and he will show you what will be yours, and no man can take it away from you. In the mighty name of Jesus, praise the Lord. This evening we are looking at the power of vision through faith. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. The power of vision through faith. What is vision? Of being able to see. Praise the Lord. The ability to think about or plan the future with imaginations or wisdom. Praise the Lord. But in the Bible, biblically, vision is that which is seen either in a dream or in a trance or in any other supernatural appearance, usually conveying revelation. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. I pray you will see vision in the name of Jesus. Your spiritual eyes will be open, and you will see what you have never seen before. You will see what you will become. You will see the impossibilities of God. You will see the hand of God in the mighty name of Jesus. Vision is a very powerful tool in the journey of life. Praise the Lord. It's a very powerful tool in the journey of life. Vision is what makes you see what has not become. Praise the Lord. Vision is what makes you to be in today and see tomorrow. Hallelujah. Vision keeps you in the present and show you the future. I pray you will see your future in the mighty name of Jesus. You will see beyond the immediate in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. A man without vision is almost destroyed. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Because what you see is what you get. Hallelujah. The extent to which you can see by faith is the extent to which you can have. Amen. Hallelujah. If you can't see it, you can't have it. But if you can see it, you can have it. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. It's either you see it with your physical eyes or you see it with your spiritual eyes before you can have it. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Just a few minutes. Can we be on our feet, each and every one of us? Hallelujah. Just be on your feet. Just for a physical demonstration. Hallelujah. Can you close your eyes? Just close your eyes. Nobody will close it for you. Close your eyes. Hallelujah. Turn to your left. Turn to your left. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Are your eyes closed? Now, go to the third seat. Don't open your eyes. Go to the third seat from where you are sitting and sit there. Don't open your eyes. Don't use your hands. Hallelujah. Go to the third seat in front of you. Sit there. Hallelujah. In front of you, from your left, as you have moved. Let somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Open your eyes and see where you are. Let somebody shout hallelujah. When you don't have vision, you can only be moving anyhow. In life, you will not move anyhow in the name of Jesus. In life, you will not move anyhow in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. It is vision that gives you direction. Praise the Lord. Amen. There was this woman. Some of us may know her. Eleanor Roosevelt. Praise the Lord. Eleanor Roosevelt was a wife to a president. Praise the Lord. She has a very long story. She was so maltreated, so thought to be invaluable and all that. Praise the Lord. And to make things worse, she was blind. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. In the course of life, she achieved so much that some people that have physical eyes will never attempt to throughout their lives. Praise the Lord. And during an interview, she was asked, what was worse than being blind? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And she said, living life without vision. Praise the Lord. May your life not be worse than that of a blind man in the name of Jesus. Amen. When you live life without vision, you are doomed. You will not be doomed in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Amen. Proverbs 29 verse 18 is a very popular verse in the Bible. And it says, where there is no vision, my people perish. The people perish. Praise the Lord. Where there is no vision, give a man wealth without vision, he is doomed. Bless a man who does not have a vision, he will never break forth. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Take a man who has no vision and provide him with everything that life demands. Come back later in life and you will see him retarded. I pray you will never be retarded in the name of Jesus. There is power in vision. A man who has nothing but has vision knows where to get what to make his life worth it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I pray you will have vision in life in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. When you have vision, you will have direction. When you have vision, you will see clearer. When you see clearer, you will go faster. Praise the Lord.
As far as you can see in life is as far as you can go. Praise the Lord. When you have a vision that will make you to see far, nothing can stop you from going far. Because when you see the treasure, the next thing you need in life is the pressure inside to get the treasure. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. The sight of the treasure puts a man under pressure to acquire the treasure. But when you cannot see it, no matter the pressure put on you, it will mean nothing to you. Your vision will make your tomorrow worth it in the name of Jesus. When you see a man who does not desire to move forward, it is nothing but the fact that he does not have vision. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. It is not out of weakness. It is mostly not out of laziness. Praise the Lord. But because there is nothing to go for, because he or she is seeing nothing. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. When you see a man who has vision, you can't stop him, because what he is seeing will always be pulling him. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. I pray you will see what will pull you in the mighty name of Jesus. What will pull you to Christ? What will pull you to excellence? What will pull you to success? What will pull you to heaven? I pray you will see what will pull you in the mighty name of Jesus. Because when a man does not see what will pull him, even if you push him, he will fall instead of moving forward. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. When a man is not seeing what will pull him, even if you force him and push him forward, instead of moving forward, he will fall down. Praise the Lord. I pray, even when you are prodded, even when you receive help from behind to push you, you will not fall in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. That is the power of vision. Vision changes who you were to whom you had to be. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Now, if you have a little child here, if you know what that child likes, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. If you know what that child likes, if you want that child to come to you, don't just call the child, come. Praise the Lord. Just bring what he likes with it. Praise the Lord. Without you are calling the child, what would the child do? Rush you. Praise the Lord. When you have vision that is great, you don't wait to be told to move. Praise the Lord. You rush in life. You go for it. I pray you will have the vision that will make you to go for things in life in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Because of our time, let's look at a few people and a few actions and happenings that shows that vision, the power of vision, is immeasurable. Praise the Lord. Where we just read, very clearly tells you that vision makes you to understand and know the mind of God. Praise the Lord. Vision makes you to know the mind of God. Hallelujah. Abraham thought it was over for him. Amen. Abraham was disturbed in the inside that he was about to leave the earth without a heir. Praise the Lord. Without anybody to represent him in the actual sense. He had people around him, but he wanted his own blood. Praise the Lord. And he thought it was not going to be possible because there was no vision that time. But immediately God came and showed him his mind. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. His mindset changed. His reasoning and understanding changed. Praise the Lord. That is why, even at any point, no matter what happened, he held on. Because he knew the mind of God. Vision will make you to know the mind of God. I pray that vision that will make you to know the mind of God, God will reveal it to you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Vision makes you to take result-oriented, unusual decisions. Praise the Lord. Let somebody open Genesis. Genesis 26. Praise the Lord. Genesis 26. Very quickly.
Genesis chapter 26. Is somebody there?
There was what? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. There was famine in the land. Praise the Lord. Under normal circumstance, as there was famine in the land continually, people were running away. Praise the Lord. People were leaving the town. But because he had vision, he saw vision, he was shown vision, praise the Lord, of the future, he stayed back. Hallelujah. It was unusual for a healthy man with family to stay back in the land where there was famine. Why? He had vision. He has seen the future. Praise the Lord. He took an unusual stand. I pray God will show you the vision that will make you to take an unusual action in the mighty name of Jesus. And at the end of the day, everything that God promised him came to pass. So shall it be for you in the mighty name of Jesus. It keeps you focused. Vision keeps you focused. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. After the series of dreams Joseph had, he knew where he was going. Praise the Lord. And that was why at every step, no matter what happened, he was focused. Praise the Lord. His brothers took him, threw him into the pit, brought him out. He didn't quarrel with anybody. Praise the Lord. No fighting, because he knew the future. Praise the Lord. He was sold. No anger. He was bought. He was in somebody's house, still very happy, because he knew the future. He has seen the vision. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Even when there was so much pressure for some of us under that condition, he would have said, this is it. But because he has seen it, he told himself, this is not what I saw. Praise the Lord. I know this will elevate me to a certain height, but this is not what I saw. Praise the Lord. It will make you, vision will make you focused. That's the power of vision. Praise the Lord. Even when there are distractions, you will not be distracted. I pray you will have the vision that will make you in life, you will never be distracted. There will be great distractions, brother. There will be great distractions, sister. But when you have vision, when you have the sight, when you have dreamt the dream, when you have known where you are going, distractions will not take you away. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. You are dressed up on a particular day and you have where you are going. Praise the Lord. Even if you meet friends along the road, you spend some time with them and you tell them, I'm going there. Is it not true? For example, if you are going to church on a Sunday and suddenly you meet a friend you have not seen for the past 15 years, you can spend some minutes and tell him, if you are like me, I'm going to church. Can you go with me? Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Or more, you can say, can we talk later in the evening? I'm going to church, because you have where you are going. But if you don't have where you are going and you just dress up and say, let me just knock about, and then suddenly you meet somebody you have not seen for 15 years. My brother, you are a game. Praise the Lord. Even if he tells you, I'm going to Lekki, you will say, let's. Praise the Lord. At most, you will call the next person to you, whether your wife or your friend or on phone, and say, I just met a friend that we have not seen for the past 15 years. He says he stays in Lekki. Let me go and see his house. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Because there was no vision. But Joseph had vision and he has seen it. He knew it. He held on. I pray by the power of heaven, the vision of your life will be shown to you, so that you will not be derailed, so that your journey will not be cut short, so that what is not worth it will not take you away from the path, in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. The power of vision. Next one is that it strengthens you to endure all that comes your way until you reach the expectations, the manifestations of your expectations. Praise the Lord. Until your faith is fulfilled. Amen. Can somebody read Hebrews chapter 12, 1 to 2? Hebrews chapter 12. Oh, yes, send it to 3. Hebrews chapter 12. Very quickly. Praise the Lord. No matter what you have been thinking, what did the Bible say is the reason why Jesus endured? You might think it's because of the love he had for you. That one is inclusive. Praise the Lord. You might think it's because he was sent. That one is inclusive. But what did the Bible say was the reason why he endured? Sister, can you read it again? Who? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do you know the reason why the race for heaven? Praise the Lord. Do you know the reason why the race for heaven is difficult for some of us? We have not seen heaven, so we don't know how it looks like. Praise the Lord. Jesus was from there, and he knew where he was going back to. Praise the Lord. So no matter what you did, hallelujah, he held on because he saw what was here. Compared it with what was there because he had sinned. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Amen. He held on. When you have the vision of where you are going, nothing can distract you. The joy of salvation, the joy of the peace of eternity can make you take any risk and withstand anything. When you see beyond where you are and where you ought to be, praise the Lord. Nothing can shake you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. When you see men go back, it is because they feel that the back where they are returning is better than where they are going. Praise the Lord. No man goes back who sees that where he is going is better than where he's coming from. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. The children of Israel heard about Canaan. But they have never seen Canaan before. At a point, they said, it will be better we return back to Egypt. Praise the Lord. Because they didn't have the true vision, true understanding of what Canaan held for them. You are finding it difficult to move forward for God because you don't know what God holds for you. If you can see what is there preserved for you, nothing can shake you. I pray God will open your eyes to see that vision that will make you unstoppable in the mighty name of Jesus. The senior prophet asked God to open the eyes of the junior prophet, praise the Lord, so that he could see those that were with them. Praise the Lord. He was afraid. He was bothered because he was seeing physical number of people. Praise the Lord. But immediately his eyes were opened and he saw that those that we are for them, we are far more than those that we are against them. Brother, he never complained again. I pray God will open your eyes. We give you a vision that will tell you what you are going through is nothing compared to where you are going to. In the mighty name of Jesus. The honor ahead is far above the shame now. Praise the Lord. The blessings ahead outweighs the labor now. Praise the Lord. You will be great in the name of Jesus. Your story will change because the thought of God concerning you is of good and not of evil. To give you an expected, not an ordinary end, not just an end, but the one that is expected. you will reach the expected end in the mighty name of Jesus. You will reach that desired end in the mighty name of Jesus. If you have seen it, you will get it in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray no power, no authority, no divination will stop you from fulfilling the vision that God has showed you in the mighty name of Jesus. The power of vision is that it keeps you going even when everything falls apart. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. You will see vision and you will not be distracted in the mighty name of Jesus. You will see vision and you will not be distracted in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. When a man has a vision, the next thing that comes to his mind is how to achieve that vision. Praise the Lord. A man that does not have vision can see instruments, equipment, materials that will help him to achieve the vision and will not know. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Amen. It is only a man that has vision that we see instruments of actualizing the vision. Praise the Lord. And know them. Amen. Amen. Instruments of fulfilling your wisdom, of your vision, will not pass you by in the name of Jesus. You will not be in ignorance of the instruments you need to actualize your vision in life in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Lastly, when you fulfill vision, it takes you from obscurity to popularity. Praise the Lord. If you see any man who holds on, who has a vision, holds on unto that vision and fulfill that vision, he will never live in obscurity again in life. He will become popular. I pray God will give you the vision that will take you from dunghill to mountaintop in the name of Jesus. The vision that will take you from obscurity to popularity in the mighty name of Jesus. Vision will make you eternally visible. Praise the Lord. When you see a man who has vision and fulfill the vision, for eternity, he will be noticeable, notable, and visible. That will be our portion in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for each and every one of us here. The power that works with vision will work in our lives. The power that brings forth the vision to a man will work in our lives. In the mighty name of Jesus. You are going to go to God in prayer. You are going to say, Father. My Father, my Father. Open my eyes. Show me my vision. And keep me on track. Go to God in prayer. Father, open my eyes, O Lord. Show me, O Lord, my vision. Show me the vision of my life. Father, open my eyes, O Lord. Show me the vision of my life. Abraham was already an already made man. Abraham had everything. Vision is not for the poor. Vision is not for the sick. Vision is not for the lowly placed. Vision is for every living man. When you are alive, you need vision. When you don't have vision, you stop where you are. Where you are now is not the best place for you. Irrespective of where God has lifted you in life, you need vision to move forward. What you can see is what you can get. To the extent you can see is to the extent you can go. What you can see is what you can have the faith to have. If you can't see it, you can't have it. But if you can see it, surely you will have it. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. That vision that will take you beyond where you are to where you ought to be, God will give you. And the power in that vision will work for you, work for your descendants, work for your generations. You will never be the same again. Because you will see beyond now and your tomorrow will be secured. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Praise the Master Jesus. Let's quickly stretch our hand to the man of God that just released the word. Let's ask the Lord to renew, to refill him, and also give him deeper vision and revelation to run this race. So shall it be in Jesus' name we pray. So shall it be in Jesus' name we pray. It's announcement time. And I pray that as you listen to this announcement, the Lord will announce you to the world in the name of Jesus. And you shall be heard by your divine helpers wherever they are located in Jesus' name. I decree in the name of Jesus that your eyes shall be opened, and whatever that is covering you, your spiritual eyes, I decree them to be opened in Jesus' name. Praise God. So, let's bless the name of the Lord for making us to see the last HOR of the month of April. Let's give him all the glory. Let's give him all the praise. Neighborhood evangelism holds tomorrow at Orelope, and the time is 8 a.m. Please, let's endeavor to be there. 70 days. And quickly, let's drop our offering as the announcement goes. And 70 days prayer blasts for Lagos power and fire explosion will kick off on the 30th of this month. Please let us partake in this prayer. And I pray even as we partake, the Lord will meet all our needs and prepare the crusade ground ahead of us in the name of Jesus. Okay. Thursday evangelism, for everyone that will be partaking in Thursday evangelism, we shall all meet here. Please take note of that before we proceed to the location announced earlier. Let's pray to the announcement. Father, we thank you for everyone that has given tonight. I pray, oh Lord, that you will bless them. And as many that wish to give and still trust in God, I pray that you visit them tonight in the name of Jesus. Please accept our offering and let your name alone be glorified. For in Jesus' name we pray.
Shout hallelujah. Are we happy? If today is your first day of fellowship, can we please see you? You are here for the first time. Anybody? Today is your first day of fellowship in here with us. If you are here, let's see you and give you your coming hand. There's nobody. God will bless us in Jesus' name. Let us know our feet as we bring the meeting to a close. Let us be on our feet. Bible told us, he said, Abraham believed, and God counted for him for righteousness. And we have gone through the city of faith in this month of February. I pray, as you go today, the faith that will make you to be reckoned with in the agenda of God, heaven is upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. There is nothing happened to man if God has not given to you. That is grace. I therefore pray grace for unwavering faith in every aspect of your life. Receive it now in the name of Jesus. Amen. By the authority of God and the power of the Holy Spirit, I ask and I pray that all you have had this month will work for you and will lift you up in faith. In the mighty name of Jesus. As you go, go and manifest faith. Go and increase in faith. Go and provide faith. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Lord, we bless you. Daddy, we worship you. We give all the glory. Daddy, to a little bit of glory in the name of Jesus. As you go, Lord, go with us. When we shall meet again, let there be testimonies. Thank you, mighty Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Shall we share the grace in fellowship? The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. The love of God. Fellowship of the Holy Spirit. Repeat us now and forevermore. Amen. And surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life. And we shall dwell in God's presence every of our life. Amen. Shout hallelujah.